Hey, I'm Chris Ariola, an engineer on the Google Maps platform developer relations team, and I'm here to share with you a new Kotlin extension library for the Places SDK for Android. This extension library enables you to use common idioms to the Kotlin programming language while using the Places SDK for Android. In this geocast, I'm going to share with you two examples, as well as how you can add this to your own app. Let's get started. Say you wanted to use the Places SDK autocomplete predictions feature to satisfy a very common craving, like trying to find the nearest place you can get pizza. To do that, you would create a find autocomplete predictions request, set properties to it, and call build. This pattern of using a builder object to construct models is a commonly used design pattern in the Places SDK. With the KTX library, creating a find autocomplete predictions request can be done using its lowercase name, followed by setting the same fields in the provided lambda. This approach enables you to create objects more expressively without the use of builders. The last feature I'd like to share with you is an alternative to writing asynchronous code with the Places SDK through the use of Kotlin coroutines. Let's take a look. Using the request object you constructed earlier, you can use the Places client to fetch predictions using the find autocomplete predictions method. This method returns a task object from which you can attach a success and a failure callback to be later notified of the result. As an alternative to this API, the Places KTX library provides an extension so that you can use coroutines to later receive the response. Rewriting the same example, you can call await find autocomplete predictions instead, and call this within a suspending function or a coroutine context to receive the response. Doing so enables you to write code in a serial manner, which really improves readability. To discover other methods you can use with coroutines, find methods within Places client that are prefixed with await. To take advantage of the features in the Places KTX library, simply add the Places KTX dependency to your app level build.gradle file. If you want to learn more, go ahead and click the Places KTX documentation page linked below. This documentation page contains a link to GitHub where you can find a demo app along with some sample code to help you get started quickly. As always, if there's anything you'd like to see, feel free to open an issue or send us a pull request. If you are also using the Maps SDK, make sure to check out the Maps KTX library, which should be linked below. As always, thanks for watching.